The economic crisis has left the Republic of Cyprus reeling, with many Cypriots very worried about what the future may bring. In the background, however, there are questions about what impact this may have on one of the oldest conflicts in the Eastern Mediterranean, an unresolved dispute that has left this island divided between Greek and Turkish Cypriots for nearly 40 years. We're now walking across the so-called Green Line. In 1974, this was basically a front line in a war between Greek and Turkish Cypriots, and it still divides the two communities. We're going over to the northern Turkish Cypriot side to hear what the cousins of the Greek Cypriots think of this economic crisis. The banks are okay here.
It's okay, not perfect.
Right. Do you feel badly for them?
Yes.
As you can see, the dividing line has grown much more relaxed over the last 10 years, and now both locals and tourists can flow freely between the north and south of Cyprus.
In the Turkish Cypriot side, we are not happy to see these bad economic developments in the Greek Cypriot side, because at the end of the day, we are living on the same island, and it may have certain negative consequences, repercussions on the Turkish Cypriot side as well.
Turkey is basically the only country in the world that officially recognizes the Turkish Republic of Northern Cyprus. And while the Greek Cypriots to the south have major financial and economic problems, here in the north, the Turkish Cypriots are experiencing their own political drama, preparing for local elections. This massive flag of the Turkish Republic of Northern Cyprus, it can be seen all the way from Greek-controlled southern Cyprus. There are some Cypriots that hope one silver lining to the financial crisis hitting the south might be an opportunity for future cooperation between Greek Cypriots and Turkish Cypriots, that perhaps this could lead to a resolution of the frozen conflict that has loomed over this divided island for nearly 40 years. Ivan Watson, CNN, Tashkent in northern Cyprus.